Hi everyone, it's Nina. Thanks for joining me today for a new video tutorial. I'm really excited to be part of Tahira's Advent Calendar Extravaganza, and I've got a card set featuring Sunny Studios products. I'm going to show you how I created these really cute little trees with the fun little ornaments on top, and I'm going to show you how I built these. So I created two sets of cards, and I showed you how I created them with Copic markers and also colored pencils. Now I'm only going to show you the coloring for the colored pencils themselves, and I'll skip through the Copic coloring process because I used very simple shading for both of these, but I wanted to show the technique that I used for the colored pencils. I took some colored pencils, these are by Derwent, and I'm using a blending brush to first blend out the base color for my trees. Then I'm going to bring in two darker shades of green, and I'm going to use some very gentle flicking motions to create some texture for the needles on the trees. I'm being careful as I color this because I don't want to create any waxy buildup with the pencil coloring. So like I said, I'm using a very light hand as I'm going ahead and adding in the shading for the coloring. The blending that I put down underneath with that blender pencil really helps make the tree have a nice smooth finish. The texture then adds a lot of interest because we have now the look of the pine needles. So I took the tree and cut it out with my fussy cut scissors, and you could use the coordinating dies that go with this set, I just don't have them. After I cut the tree out, I used some rainbow sparkle gems from Lucy's cards, and I'm adding these all over the tree in a variety of different colors and sizes and creating some really cute little ornaments. I'm making sure to apply down some collage medium underneath each one, and the collage medium I really like using as the adhesive underneath embellishments like this because I know it's going to hold down really nicely, and it also has a nice matte finish. After I've added on all of the little embellishments, I'm then going to take a piece of gold mirror cardstock from Tonic Studios, and I'm going to cut the holiday shapes die set from Simon Says Stamp into that paper. This comes with both hearts and stars, but I'm only going to be using a couple of the stars from this die set. I'm going to run this through my Sidekick machine because this is such a small die, I don't need to break out my big machine, which I will use for later on in the card. I'm taking a couple of the stars from that die set and I'm going to glue them onto the top of each of my little trees. Once I have these stars adhered, I'm going to set these trees aside. And again, like I said, I used Copic markers and colored pencils to create two different styles of trees, but the cards that each of these trees are used on are created exactly the same, which I'm going to show you here. I'm taking a piece of blue cardstock and a new Simon Says Stamp die from their December release. And this is the arched stitching border die set. I'm using the pinked edge, and I'm gonna cut a bottom portion off of my panel, and this is going to be the panel that my scene is going to be built on. I'm also going to take a stitched rectangle die and cut the edges to trim it down and also give a nice finished edge and look to the card design. It's also going to coordinate perfectly with the stitching detail that's on the pinked edge down towards the bottom. I'm bringing in my Mini Misty now and a sentiment from another Sunny Studios stamp set, and I'm going to align this onto my panel, making sure it's in the center, but I'm also using one of the Misty accessory tools to go ahead and make sure that I've lined this up perfectly straight on my card. I'm bringing in some clear embossing ink, and I'm going to stamp that down onto the surface of my paper. I did already prep the surface with my powder bag just to make sure I don't have any extra cling or static on my paper. That'll give me a nice clean heat embossed sentiment, which I use some gold embossing powder to do. After I've embossed the sentiment, I can start doing some ink blending because the embossing powder is going to resist the ink that I'll apply on top of it. This is some Blueprint Sketch Distress Ink. Now you could also do the ink blending first and then stamp the sentiment, but because I was going to heat emboss this, I knew that the distress ink would take a while to dry, so I wanted to make sure I did the embossing first because I knew, like I said, it would resist the ink. So I wouldn't have to worry about any extra powder particles sticking to any areas of ink that might not be fully dry. I blended in just a little bit of that blue color towards the top of the card, and then I'll wipe off my Art Impressions palette, which is just a plastic palette with my little L'Enfant scrubby, but that palette is perfect for doing ink blending on because it resists the ink also, and it's a really great surface to work on. I'm taking that pinked edge again, and I'm going to cut it from some white cardstock. This is going to be the snowy hill that the trees will sit on. I'm going to turn this into more of a hill by using a L'Enfant stitched hillside border die, and I'm going to cut just a little bit off of that border that we created with the arched stitching border die. I'll add adhesive to the backside of this piece of paper and attach this down, lining it up with the pink edges that are on the bottom of the card already. Once I've adhered this down, I can bring in my trees. These I'm going to attach down with some foam tape. I put a layer of foam tape behind each one. I'll start by putting the biggest one in the center, and then I'll arrange the two smaller ones flanking either side of the tree. At this point, the embellishments and everything are dry on the tree, and this is also a great look at the Copic colored version of the trees that I had done for this card also. Now there's another new die set from Simon Says Stamp that I was really excited to work with, and this is the Sparkling Snowflakes die set. This set has some really cute stitching details included in it also, but I wanted the snowflake shapes because I liked A, how small they were, and B, the style. I thought it looked really nice with the trees and the style of the card that I'm creating. So I took quite a few of the snowflakes and also quite a few of the little circle snowflakes, and I'm going to adhere these down onto the background using some collage medium. So I'll arrange these and then adhere them all down, and here you can see them already attached, and I did add a few Studio Cutia clear droplets on top of the largest dots, and that adds a lot of really fun dimension to those snowflakes in the background. I also popped up the entire panel onto a white card base with also a piece of red pattern paper from Doodlebug's Milk and Cookies collection. Finally, I'm bringing in some Nouveau Glitter Drops. This is the white blizzard color, and I'm adding this in certain areas around the trees to make it look like snow. I really think this adds a lot of nice finishing detail to the trees and helps ground them a little bit more on that white hillside that we've got them sitting on top of. And I really like how the finished result looks and how sparkly and beautiful these cards are. Here's a look at both the Copic colored version and the colored pencil style, and you can see that they both have a totally different feel, but yet both have such a beautiful appearance. So I hope you enjoyed this video and got some inspiration on using some Sunny Studios products, and also I hope you will check out Tahira's Advent Calendar Extravaganza over at her blog. I have all of the details and links over at my blog, so make sure you head on over there to check that out. There's also giveaways, so I encourage you to head on over there. If you enjoyed this video, here are two more you might like featuring some fun holiday projects. Thanks again for stopping by and spending some time with me. I will see you again very soon with another video. Bye!